It's the last day of the Federal Parliament's current sitting period, and time to find out just how badly our chosen politicians have been sleeping. It's also the perfect time to apply some pressure. After 2 weeks of marathon late-night parliamentary sessions, back-to-back early morning meetings, and endless press conferences, we are about to find out just how damaging even a short period of poor sleep can be. First, we'll retest some key indicators, like reaction time.
Good God. I don't think I'll drive home.
10 days of working in the nation's capital has taken its toll.
175 on 100.
It's not good.
And your pulse is 70 now.
Yeah.
Barnaby Joyce's blood pressure has gone from high to dangerously high.
Next.
Hello.
Hello.
Did you bring me in a pillow? Because God, I need one.
You want to see how you went?
Yeah.
Woo-hoo.
All right. So on a 10-point scale, you're at about 8 in terms of just how sleepy you are right at this moment, right now. Knackered.
That's politely putting it.
Yeah. Blood pressure.
Very
high. Very high to begin with. And, you know, it's a 25-point increase over the last couple of weeks. Here's what we see in terms of your reaction time. It's gone up a huge amount. As you said, I'm glad you're not going to drive home.
Yeah.
Don't. The one on your arm, the blood glucose measures.
Yeah.
A week ago, you're sitting at about 5.3. Then it's gone up to 6.6. So it's been creeping up all week.
Pushes you into the pre-diabetic range.
Great.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. You see, at the start, it's all right. It's been here.
Doesn't add up to a good lifestyle.
Everyone's seen a deterioration in some or all of their indicators. So what's been happening with their sleep?
When we looked at your oxygen levels very closely, we found a pattern that's consistent with obstructive sleep apnea.
Do you know what that is?
Snoring?
Basically, you stop breathing.
Yeah, right.
Quite long periods of time.
Great.
Which is not good for your brain.
Three or four nights where you're up around right on the edge of what we'd actually call severe sleep apnea. Some nights it's happening every couple of minutes.
But how long do I stop breathing for?
About 30 seconds at a time.
How many years does that take off my life?
Well, yeah. You have a little awakening when this happens.
Does it sound familiar?
Sounds scary.
It's scary.
Do you snore? I don't know. I haven't had a man in my bed for 20 years. So yeah, I can assure you, so no one's making any complaints.
Every politician we tested is now sleeping less. Some have clear signs of insomnia.
Some of these nights you've been here working in the Senate, 5 hours of sleep.
Others have insomnia and sleep apnea.
You've got what we call COMISA, comorbid sleep apnea and insomnia. On average, people with that combination, they die earlier.
Great.
Thank you.
You can do something about it. That's the point. And I guess that's kind of what we want to say.
Yeah.
Okay.
With women, the risk of sleep apnea really increases when they become perimenopausal and go through the menopause.
Do you have any good news for women once they start going into menopause and getting old? Is there anything good for us?
The best thing that happens to women is they stop trying to please everybody else.
We have attitude and we just don't give a
Exactly. Exactly right. You're passionate about being a politician, doing what you're doing. But we want you to do that job, but not at the expense of your health. And I think it's an unhealthy workplace. And I think it needs change.
What would you do? No, this is a crazy boarding school. It's really like, you haven't been to boarding school? Become politicians, pretty close.
You know, making decisions and things and you haven't had much sleep, or there's alcohol. Mm. Isn't it time that we fix this workplace?
Yeah, I suppose it's, I'm trying to work out, you know, how you do that.
I've seen people whose lives have been completely transformed by actually changing, by some of the things that these guys do.
Worth thinking about. Okay, well, no, I'll do more than think about it. Oh, okay. Because it's now on television.
Yeah.
Our politicians had worsening sleep patterns across the sitting fortnight with serious health consequences. Hopefully this will send a message to get sleep back on the political agenda and start changing lives across Australia.